Hello and welcome back to the Neon Chronicles. It has been quite a while since I've been able to post an actual video here for the channel. I have actually been traveling for the last couple weeks and then I got back and work was just insane. So I have been catching up on games. I've been doing some videos. I want to do videos for, you know, reviews of Zenless Zone Zero that I've gotten to start now. Wuthering Waves with big updates coming up and some pretty big announcements that we have for Everness to Neverness, I think is gonna be the name, the new Tower of Fantasy game. So very exciting updates, but the first thing that I wanted to cover being back is, in my opinion, just the very insensitive and neglectful appropriation that I'm realizing is gonna just be what happens for Natlan in Genshin Impact. So I've been able to play this game for the last 4 years, and I love that every region feels unique. The way it felt like China, Inazuma feels like Japan, and then when we started to shift to Sumeru is where the problems started to come to the surface. Haytham being whitewashed, Nilou being whitewashed, and then with Fontaine, the conversation got derailed because of France, and that also felt very authentic to France. And now with the announcement of Natlan, the first focus was really more on just creatures and I think the traversal of the regions, which concerns me all on its own because now the game's starting to feel like PAL World, if anything, more than Genshin Impact in my opinion. It just feels kind of childish. The region doesn't feel authentic to Latin America or South America or Africa. And honestly, I think it's disappointing to see that they feel like it's appropriate to categorize all these regions into one. And then on top of that, make it whitewashed. As you can see, we have petitions going around. I'm sure you've been keeping up with the news, but people are tweeting, people are mad. And I think it's warranted. As a Latino myself and somebody who, you know, in the winter, I get pretty pale. In the summer, I get very tan. I just wanted to see a broad spectrum of that representation. I get that it doesn't have to be all tan skins, all dark skins, all brown skins, but at least give us a little color, you know? Just, if you're gonna borrow from our culture, try to do it in a way that feels appreciative of it, not appropriative. You can see some voice actors are speaking out to this, and Pokemon is a perfect case study for how they were able to introduce black or dark skinned characters that honestly are some of the best in their roster. So when you compare that to what we're seeing here for Natlan, I think it's wildly disappointing because HoYoverse has been a company that has had such good representation, at least in the themes, the motifs, the visual motifs. They felt like they were capturing the essence of each culture. And for them to, you know, split Mondstadt, which is like Germany, from Fontaine, which is like France, they get totally different regions, and then Africa and South America just gets grouped into one. I don't know. I'm not about it. Definitely not where I wanted the journey of the game to go. Definitely not the style and art direction that I was expecting for the region that represents my own home country. I see some traces of maybe a carnival for some of the characters because I was born in Brazil. But other than that, I feel pretty disappointed with the direction that they're taking. And I hope that they choose some better choices. But if you agree or if you disagree, let us know in the comments. I think this is a conversation that should be had in groups, not in silos. So please do leave your thoughts below. For me, I will be boycotting. I won't be spending any money in the game for the release of the region until they release an actual dark-skinned character. And if you like this video, if you agree, then a like, a subscribe is always helpful too. But thank you for joining today, and like I said in the beginning, more to come very soon.